System, that the national government should trust all of you and your colleagues as true partners in our intergovernmental system. Throughout 81 and 82, we've worked together many times on block grants, regulatory relief, and a variety of other intergovernmental issues. I think we can be pleased by the progress that's been made thus far and how much we've all learned in the development of the Federalism initiative. Let me review what I think we can all agree upon. That we need to return government responsibilities to the state and local level. These returned responsibilities should be accompanied by commensurate revenue sources or an appropriate funding mechanism such as the Federalism Trust Fund. There should be a mandatory pass-through to protect local units of government. The initiative should not be a vehicle for budgetary savings on either side. I know there are some areas where we couldn't reach agreement earlier this year, but let me assure you, I've made no final decisions in those areas, and I'd like to hear your input firsthand about any outstanding issues or other approaches which we might consider to achieve our mutual goals. As I said to many of you when we talked in August, I thought it would be appropriate for all of us to take a step back and rethink many aspects of the initiative. I think it can be very healthy for you and your organization to develop alternative comprehensive plans, and I look forward to receiving them. But what I would like to do most at this meeting today is to hear from you, and I'll call on Rich Williamson here to recognize the heads of each of the organizations that are represented here.
Thank you, Mr. President. We're going to start out with Bill Murphy, new president of the National Association of Counties. Bill.
Thanks, Rich. Mr. President, it's a pleasure to see you again. It's always nice to see you in such good health. Our best wishes to go with you for much success. Mr. President, two things I'd like to address with you. First, with the 1984 budget, that is a word of caution from county governments throughout this country. The recession is having a very heavy impact on those county budgets, and as you know, they are largely financed by real property taxes. Those taxes in almost all the counties in this country, you as an association, do not to cut further into those programs that affect county governments in this country, at least while the recession is going on, because we are in no position to be able to pick up the additional cost that those cutbacks would engender. At the present time, our welfare rolls are swelling because of unemployment. Our Medicaid rolls are going up at a rate faster than anyone could ever have imagined. Food stamp program has obviously grown, and now there's been a 6 or 7% increase in that. Our jails are overcrowded, our criminal justice system is bad, and I wish I could end it up by saying, but everything else is okay, all right, pretend it's a joke, but it simply is not. So as far as that budget is concerned, our strong recommendation would be no further cuts. We can adjust to the cuts that have come down already until we get out of this recession and turn the corner onto this prosperity, which I'm confident you're going to bring this country. Secondly, as it relates to new federalism,
okay, it's on.
Okay. It's good.
Prisoner, as you well know, ladies and gentlemen, is the president of the Espriella of Panama. We're very pleased to have you.
The place we have with President Reagan, we're going to talk about the cultural interest of our country. Thank you.
President, can you tell us about the Lebanon situation and the Marines? How do you feel about what happened?
You know, I'm not supposed to answer questions at the press opportunity, but I can't know the tragedy, of course. It's a great tragedy for all of us. It's terrible about it.
Will it change your commitment,
Mr.
President, to the Marines staying?
They're staying.